can make you work until you die, maggot.
Oh! look good for someone who just clawed his way out of Durgesh. Thank Kira we found you before you froze to death.
How did you find me?
Kira showed me the way. It took a week to track you down. I prayed constantly for your safe return, and the gods made it so.
Thank you.
Don't thank me. Thank Kira. Besides, keeping you alive is good for the cause. That's one thing Amita doesn't understand. I'll always have your back, brother.
We'll be right back. Attention, people of Kirat, this is Pagan Mim. It appears that a guest of Tugesh Prison has gone missing. If any of my subjects sees one R.J. Gale, I request that you immediately contact any of my Royal Army soldiers so that I can take swift action and ensure that Mr. Gale is where he belongs. Do not attempt to apprehend him yourself. Leave this up to the professionals.
You're a drug peddler! That's what you are! Who do you remind me of? Oh yes, Pagan.
I'm like Pagan because I have a vision for Kirat. I'm trying to take us out of your third world bullshit.
It's our history, our culture, our traditions.
Tradition? Like what? Marrying little girls, is that it? Is that your big plan for Budra? Oh, go for it. Go ahead, show RJ what kind of man you are.
I don't answer to you. It's Noor's turn.
At least we agree on that.
She didn't have a choice. Pagan forced Noor to do those things. He had her family.
And how many families did she kill to save her own?
Doesn't matter why she did it. She has to pay, just like everyone else.
I'll decide what happens to Noor.
Did I ever tell you about Noor? This is one of my favorites. She used to be a doctor, quite the benevolent soul. She came to Kirat on some aid mission in the early days of my reign. She had the audacity to write a report on the human rights abuses perpetrated by my regime. So I reached out to her, invited her to come back to see the improvements, how we'd acted on her recommendations. I extended the invite to her family. So she came. Husband and kids. I put them up in the palace. I even put on a meeting for her. I made a PowerPoint to a 12-step action plan to address Kirat's human rights violations. Except each slide was about how I was going to ruin Noor's life. So Paul Deplore kept her family hostage while I forced the great humanitarian Dr. Najjar to run the most terrible parts of my Kirati Empire. Oh, between you and I think she actually enjoys it now.
getting in that way. Right. Time for plan B.
Welcome to my shop, the Jewel of Kirat. Thank you. Bye-bye.
You should stay away from the arenas. Try making pottery instead.
Right, time for plan B.
Oh! weak. Stick to the plan.
Cast in the fickle, mistress. None are immune to the rivers of fate.
Yes! Guards, find and kill the idiot in the control room. You hear me, Eivor? You're done.
Moving out. It's Luke Foster.
Somebody's in the control room.
Hold the line. Secure the control room. He can't stay here forever.
He's in the control room.
People of Kirat, I've given you winners to cheer for, and losers to mock. None so bloody, so desperate as today's gladiators. But there is always more blood to come!
Eiti, where's my family?
I'm sorry, Noor.
No!
I'm so sorry. Sorry. Pagan. Pagan had them killed years ago.
I don't need your pity. I want my family back.
Look, I'm sorry, but you're free now.
Free. Free. Free from what? All the people I've killed? From everything I've done? I gave them this taste for blood. Your blood. Mine.
Isn't that what you want? More blood! Here! Take more! Take all of it, you fucking animals! Now I'm free.
Sabal, it's done. Noor's dead.
The demon Yalung has special plans for her. I promise you that. You did good, brother. The South is finally ours, and the people are starting to believe again. Even though some fools refuse to learn,